Michelle, fight for that white gold. This one for them hood girls, them good girls, straight masterpieces. Styling, wilding, living it up in the city.
I was just about to, oh, am I on? Can you hear me? Am I on yet? Okay. I was just about to do a dance and realised, no. I was like, that's not, no. Thank you for having me on. It's absolutely a massive, massive honour to obviously be on this stage. And it's funny, actually, because, and I'll start off with this story because I probably shouldn't, because this is why I got in trouble in the first place. I was here last year and I said to Simon, I was talking to Simon at the party. He said, I'd love to have you on stage, Sinead. Your problem is you swear all the time. And I was like, I'm really sorry. Actually, my answer was probably worse. But I'm trying not to get there today. But it's a massive, massive honour to be here. This has been the most incredible couple of days with the company. And to be asked to close today is just absolutely insane. So thank you very, very much for having me. I want to talk to you guys today about making a change and what it means to make a difference. The reason I wanted to do this is because everyone talks about everyone says that they want to make a change. Like, we have this big board outside, everyone is writing down their commitments. We say we want to make a change, but then people walk away from here and they don't actually do anything. And it's a trend that happens all the time. Obviously, not everyone is going to take action, but really what I want you guys to think about is you've heard some incredible speakers over the last couple of days. Like, when you walk away from this, what are you actually going to change? Like, what are you willing to do to put the work in to get the results that you want? Today is the day where you really want to be getting rid of excuses and really remembering why you're here, right? Because I know that most people in the room have children. You've had to kind of sort out childcare. We have an amazing creche right now. I can completely relate. My little girl's over there right now. It's incredible. But like, there are so many things. There's a reason you're here. You've sacrificed something already to come. And to walk away from this event, I really want you to think about what you're going to do from this. What are you gonna sacrifice? And there are so many sacrifices I've made through my business. Every single one of them was worth it, trust me. I want to tell you a little bit about myself, right? So I joined Juice Plus almost 3 years ago. I was working in a corporate environment. I was working 50 odd hours a week. I wasn't afraid of working hard, but I was really unhappy. I was in a situation where I finished my degree, I went to work, and I'd probably been, I was what, 25, so working in corporate environments for about 5-6 years, had no holiday, I never took time off, I was always working extra hours, and I was in that mindset that to get ahead, you have to work really, really hard, and I wasn't afraid to work really hard, but I wasn't getting ahead. The company that I worked at, I had already done a couple of promotions. I was a sales manager for that company, and I remember this position came up for a promotion, and I said, okay, I'm going to go for it. I was already doing kind of the job anyway, and I went for it. I went for the promotion. My director took me aside and said, Sinead, it's kind of between you and one of the other guys. The problem is we're not going to give it to you. We're going to give it to him because we have never had a girl at this level in the company, and we're not willing to change that. If you know me, you imagine my reaction. I was fuming. And he then said, but you're doing a really good job. So what we want to do is we're going to split the workload. You can do half, but I was getting no reward. So I said no, because I'm not an idiot. And I was just like, where is my life? I was 25, which I appreciate. I probably was going through like a midlife crisis, or like quarter life crisis, whatever you call it. But like, it was crazy. I was 25, I was unhappy. I just felt like I wasn't appreciated, right? And that's kind of what happens when you work for these companies, because they really don't give a but that's kind of how it goes. And then alongside that business, I was in that company for a couple of years, and then alongside that, I had this new kind of exciting part-time thing I did in the evening, and my Juice Plus business was exciting me more than my normal job. And it got to a point where I really had to start looking at what I wanted in life and making some decisions. So I was working really hard behind the scenes on my Juice Plus business. I was building it up. I got to the position of senior sales coordinator in the evenings, in the sort of stolen moments of the day. And my business, you know, everything was going really well until I found out I was pregnant. And then for me, everything changed. When I found out I was pregnant, I just really had to look at what I was doing with myself, what kind of lifestyle I wanted to live. I never, by the way, this is way before I even envisioned things like presidential marketing director. I didn't really think people were making that much money. Like, I thought it was all a bit of a scam still. Like, it was kind of funny. But I just wanted to be in a position where I wanted to raise my own kid. Like, I wanted to be at home with her. Like, I wanted to do the mum thing. But because I was always working really hard, I thought, well, that's never gonna happen for me, right? So I kind of had this big thing. I had to make that decision. And it was just kind of crazy because I had to make that decision and my boyfriend was so amazing. He was just like, you hate your job and it's just making you miserable. And I really wanna see you happy because he's the best guy ever. And I quit my job and I really started going into Juice Plus like wholeheartedly. Probably the best decision apart from him that I've ever made, right? So what I want to say though is this really, really takes work. And the reason was I was trying to look forward at what my life would look like in 10 years. If you've never done this, really, really do this. Look, try and think of where you are now, job-wise, money-wise, you know, housing, relationships, whatever. Envision 10 years' time. If nothing changes now, in 10 years, are you going to be where you want to be? Like, I'm from a council estate in London. There's really nothing extraordinary about me. My mum used to work 4 or 5 jobs all the time to raise me and my 2 sisters. And I used to watch her work really, really hard. And, you know, there wasn't that time that we had as a family. I didn't want that. And that's okay, right? So if you're in a situation where you don't want what you want, that's fine. You can make that decision. One thing I knew from the very beginning was that with this business, with this opportunity, I was never, ever, ever going to look at my child in the face and say, I could have done better, but I didn't. Or I could have done better for you, but I couldn't be bothered to go to that event. Or there was a call on that night, but I couldn't be bothered to listen to it. I couldn't be bothered to make that journey. I couldn't be bothered to make that trip. Like, think about all the trivial stuff that we do in our day-to-day, the ridiculous TV shows. Like, they're not gonna actually add value to you, your family, the generations to come. That was something I was not prepared to do, ever. So I got to work, I quit my job, and it was probably one of the best things I ever did. Oh, I've gone ahead a minute, 1 second. So I'm gonna go back to this. So when I was doing that, obviously my business grew. It was 2 years ago, I came to this convention. I was heavily, heavily pregnant. And it just, you know, these things, I love these conventions because you always learn something all the time. Like, I was sat backstage and I wasn't really ready because Gordon was on and I was making notes. And it's just kind of crazy, but my business has grown. And what I was gonna kind of reiterate from that is, from through my pregnancy, through these decisions, I got to presidential marketing director, but then something else happened and I just wanted change, right? And change is okay. And my whole presentation is about change. And if there's something that you want to change, I want you to realize that it's possible for you the same way it was possible for me. It was 2 years ago we came here. My boyfriend is, as brilliant as he still did not like the company very much. So if you guys have partners or friends who give you and they say it's not real, it's a scam, you'll never make money, these people are fake, we all get it, right? I actually, a few months ago, I was accused of being a paid actor, and I don't know if it means I'm a really good actor, because I'm not, but I was just, people are ridiculous, right? They have something to say. So I was in a situation again, like, he really did not believe in the business, but when we went to the Barcelona conference, that was, and again, I used to drag him along to everything. I don't drive, I'm ridiculous, right? So I'd always drag him along as like my chauffeur and make sure he came to all the events with me. He would be the one at the back that's always trying to get out the room. And it took Barcelona, after all of these big conferences, for him to realize that it was something that he wanted as well. So then that was when our daughter was about 4 or 5 months old. That's when he decided he wanted it. So not only has Juice Plus given me a life where I'm at home with my daughter, where, you know, I can be a mum and I can have a business and I can have my own money and my own independence. But now my boyfriend, this was a year and a half ago, he quit his job. And financially, we could have done that probably before, but he didn't quit his job because we had the finances. We had the finances long before he quit his job. He quit his job because he loved the business. And now he's here, he's got his own team, like, he's doing amazing, he's NMD, and I love him the most. And it's just kind of one of those things, and it gave us opportunities. When you make change and you make a decision and it makes a massive difference in your life, it doesn't change you, it changes everyone around you. So it's just done so much for us. And now he's got this big growing business. It allowed us last year to go on 15 family holidays, which is insane. For like 5 years before that, hadn't gone anywhere. And I don't think actually we'd been on many holidays. We were speaking about this. My boyfriend, his first holiday, he got his first passport, I think, when he was about 25 years old. And my daughter was a month. And she's already been on 15 holidays. The kid is spoiled and she's so ungrateful. But no, she's cute. And it's just absolutely crazy how these things can happen. Like, we were like Dubai, Bali, Mexico. Like, there's just, it's just given us so much. And the fact is, we always work really, really hard, regardless of where we are. And that's the beauty of our business as well, because you can work from absolutely anywhere. And one thing I was going to say as well is it doesn't really hit you until you watch it happen in other people, not just those that are close to you. I had the absolute pleasure today of watching so many of my guys on this stage. And to see them hit promotions and to see them hit positions, and to know the stories behind that, to know how much has helped them, how much has changed things in their circumstances, you know, paying off debts, buying new cars because their car kept breaking down, those kind of things. It's pretty incredible. And it's just amazing. That's what our business is. And if you're here, hopefully you feel that, because it's the best business absolutely ever in the world. So I'm going to talk to you guys about kind of how you guys can make that change. Now, there were very simple things I've done with my business, and my team do the same things, of how we make these changes in our businesses. And they really are about focusing on the right things and not getting sidetracked. Of course, you heard today about you have to have like unlimited belief in yourself and you have to be consistent. But then you're thinking, consistent in what? Like, what am I supposed to be consistent in? I'm here, I'm on Facebook, like I do the stuff that I'm told to do. I put a picture up. That's not consistency, and they those things are not gonna grow your business. So I'm gonna go through a couple of pointers hopefully you guys will take away from of really what has made a massive impact in my business. When I did this, I was, to go back a couple of years, I was like senior sales coordinator. I still think around the October time. I'd quit my job, I think it was August-ish. So I had kind of a plateau bit where I didn't really grow very much because I didn't know how to. Probably some of you guys are feeling that right now. This is what I've changed. And then from that position, like I think it was October, I decided I wanted to be NMD by the end of January, and I did. And All of the points I'm going to go through next, all the actions I took to get me to that position. So it was October 2013. November 2013, I went qualified national marketing director. Then by the January, I hit NMD. And then because of what I'm about to go through, everything in my business absolutely compounded. And it grew at a level I'd never, ever knew. And before I even knew it, I think I went NMD like the end of January. Then my business doubled. I was IMD by the end of February. Then my business doubled again in 2 weeks. And then I was EMD by the middle of March. And then a week later, I was a presidential marketing director, heavily pregnant, didn't have a clue what was going on. And it was just mad. So I really want to go through. I knew it was going to happen, but I didn't know where. So I really want to go through some of these with you guys. So the first thing I want to go through is really about developing a positive attitude and really understanding what a positive attitude means. A positive attitude isn't just being good on Facebook or being smiley on Facebook. In fact, all the stuff I'm going to go through is what goes on behind the scenes. It's what happens when no one's watching you. It's when you're not at an event. It's when you're not on a call. It's when you're at home on your own, or when you're out on your own, or whether you're driving to an event, but you're thinking, I'm a bit knackered actually. I really want to just go home and go to bed. But you carry on and you persevere. A positive attitude is what happens behind the scenes. I always get asked, right, how do you motivate people? And to be totally honest, you can't. It's absolutely impossible. The only thing you can do is really work on yourself, because if you keep yourself motivated, people are going to buzz that energy is going to buzz off you, and they're going to get that vibe off you anyway. And it really is about finding out what works for you. We're all completely different. What works for me might not work for you. And do you know what? It's funny about positive attitude, because I remember speaking to Emma Karen when I wanted my business to grow, and I was like, how do I do this, and how am I going to get to this income, because I really want to quit my job. And she just says, work on yourself, like, are you happy? And I'm like, babe, I'm happy. And she's like, no, work on yourself, like, develop. She was always all the fundamentals, have a positive attitude, because, and I was focusing on the wrong thing. Because all I had to do was focus on myself, a positive attitude and what was going to help me build my business. And actually, there was a thing she told me as well. I was kind of stuck in limbo. And she said to me, you're only interested in the business. And I was thinking, well, I've quit my job. I'm pretty interested. And she was like, no, you need to be committed. And that was when you develop a positive attitude for yourself that you know works for you, that's when you're committed. That's when you know you're going to make a change. When you make that change, the difference will happen for everything around you. You need to know what your positive attitude is. Mine is I listen to Beyonce every day. Love that girl. Like, I listen to Beyonce every morning. I shake my big fat right around the house. And I absolutely love, like, it just really gets me in the right zone for the day. I think my boyfriend is food. Because I know when he's hungry, he's miserable. So know where you are, right? Know what keeps your attitude as well. And then keep that going every single day. Next one I'm going through with you guys is really respect your customers. Now, the reason I'm saying this is because I don't think I've heard too many people speak about customers today, even though I know behind the scenes everyone's there tapping away, getting a new order in. But respecting your customers is our business. If we have no customers, we haven't got a business. If your team don't have customers, you have a social club. Like, that's not a business. That's not going to pay you. That's not going to buy a house. That's not going to get you anywhere. So really respect your customers and really focus on how you can help people outside of your customers. So I wrote building your audience. I'm massive on social media. I feel like social media is the easiest thing in the world when you get it right. Because if you're focusing on one-on-one conversations, you're doing this all the time, eventually you're going to burn out. Social media, you can have a conversation with 100, 300, 1,000 people at the same time. And for you, that's massive because our business is everywhere. And you can build your business everywhere. And that's what I meant by focusing and building on your audience. Because when you build on that and you focus on that, that's attention to detail. That means that more people, that's more eyes on you, right? When you focus on helping people, they're gonna get a different, oh no, Kaylee, take away from me, I'll cry. If you focus on helping other people and actually giving value to, that was my daughter, by the way, not just randomly shooing people off. When you really focus on helping them, they're going to get something out of you it's come from a better place. It's not selfish. That can kind of be where we go wrong with social media as well. We spend a lot of time talking about ourselves when really we need to spend more action and more time really thinking about how we can help someone else. When you start doing that, everything changed. Pretty much my whole front line were customers. Customers who loved the product. Now, not be funny. When you have someone come in your business and they love the product, how easy is it, right? That's like the hardest bit. It makes it 10 times easier if they love the product already because you don't even have to talk about it all the time. They already have their own story. It just makes sense. So focus on your customers. Focus on your audience. Your audience could be anything from your social media to whatever it is, people that you know, and really expanding on that and really networking on that, right? That's why it's called network marketing, because it's about the network that you have around you. Really focus on your values. So the next one to go for is understand that this really is your opportunity. There will be people who walk out of here and there will be people in this room right now who are only interested in figuring out what they're going to wear tonight. Genuinely. For you guys, I don't even know why you're here, if I'm totally honest, because the party's going to be sick anyway. But like, it's just, that's not why we're here. People are here because they're hungry for change, right? We want to do something. This is your opportunity to make something massive. Like, you don't even know yet. This is your opportunity to make a change. This is your opportunity to start networking with other people, start finding people who are doing better than you, finding out what works for them, and networking with them and you know, introducing your new guys. So that's what this is about. This really is your opportunity. No one's going to go to work for you. Do you know we always say, like, this is an opportunity where you can grow and you can build these things because you go and you work for these big companies and these companies don't really care about us because they care about themselves. They care about their own profit. They care about their own shares. They care about themselves. It's the same as everything else. No one's going to come into your team and work harder for you than for your... Why would they? They work hard for themselves. If you want something, you have to work hard for yourself. That's what it's about. The thing that we love and what we have is that everyone works together. But this is your time. Don't just sit here thinking, well, my team are mint, they're just going to build around me. This is your opportunity to grow. And that's what you should do, because that's the whole point, right? We have the best opportunity, the best business, we've got the best leadership, we've got Simon Bowler, who's amazing, and Dan Holtzman, who was here yesterday, if you heard him speak, and we've got Sven Goebel yesterday, if you heard him speak. They're pushing our whole business into a new era. But this is our opportunity to really take hold of that, because if you don't, the people next to you are going to, and they're going to have the life that you want, and you'll be watching them still on Facebook, and in a year's time, they'll be on stage, and then you'll either be sat at the back clapping away like you were now, if you don't mind me saying that, I'm a bit rude like, but it's one of those things, or you'll be at home going, oh, it's a load of rubbish, that company, I used to work for them. But that's what happens. This is your opportunity, no one's going to do it for you, this is your time to get to work. I'm going to ask you, so I'm going to ask you guys as well, is find people who inspire you, and we're all different, so hopefully you're going to get a good vibe out of this. Find people who inspire you and follow them and work, not literally, hey John, follow them around the street, but find people who inspire you and kind of take direction of what they're doing. There are people on this stage, right, Bob Burdick, 84 events a month he did, every month for years. Do you think he looks back and goes, do you know what, maybe one of them was a bit of a mistake, only three people turned up. Multi-millionaire, he don't care. It's the action that built his business. Just do the things like that. It's action that builds your business. Find people who inspire you and do what they do, because what they're doing is working. And also find people outside of our business that inspire you, because it's just amazing. Just find people who are doing it. There are so many stories of these celebrities who came from nothing and they're doing it now. Make it your mission to find people like that in and out, inside and outside of our business, and use it to fuel you, use it to motivate you, because when it motivates you, it keeps you going, and that's all you need. When you have inspiration, by the way, it drives you to places that you don't even know, so hopefully you guys will see that. And obviously, my biggest thing is you have to work hard. Nothing comes free, nothing is easy. Our business, in total honesty, is easy when you get, it's a piece of if you really get to grips with it, it really is. All you got to do is speak to people. We love the products, just speak to people about it. When you, just having Facebook isn't enough, putting a picture up isn't enough. Putting up 4 or 5 pictures a day isn't enough. It's the action behind the scenes that people need. The action behind the scenes is what builds your business. It's actually talking to people, picking up the phone. How many of us avoid the phone, by the way? All the time, over there, hey, straight away. But it's all the time. We don't even use the phone anymore. So think about it. When you ring someone, they might even know they have a phone, a ringtone anymore. It'd be so excited to speak to a human being. Just pick up the phone. It's just easy. All it is actually speaking to people, and that's what our business is. We're a people business, we're a relationship business. Make it about someone else, have fun, and just realise that it is work. It's a little bit of hard work, it's a little bit of fun work, but it definitely is work. Have fun and just enjoy the whole journey, because everything together is amazing. I've got 13 seconds left. I'm pretty happy with that timing. Thank you very... Oh, no, one more. Sorry. my last one with you guys is really figure out where you are right now and where you are right now, what you're going to do next. What is your pinnacle change you're going to make right now today, or the commitment that you're going to make to yourself today that you're actually going to do to drive your whole business forward? Because where you are right now, if you're not happy to thinking that you're going to be there in 5-10 years, you need to make that change today. And it's only you that can do it. No one's going to do that for you. No one's going to buy you a house. No one's going to take you on holiday. No one's going to buy you a car. It's your own life. So hopefully you guys have taken some value from me today. Thank you so much for having me speak. And thank you to everyone. Take care.